subscribe to this channel and turn on your notification bell icon. Thank you. Hello, my wonderful people, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm here to give you an update coming from Ondo State governorship election. Many injured, over 20 vehicles, motorcycles destroyed as APC, PDP supporters clash in Owo. Political violence rocked Ipele community in Owo local government area of Ondo State on Tuesday, as supporters of the candidate of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, Eitayo Jegede, and that of the All Progressive Congress, APC, clashed. The clash was said to have occurred when the campaign train of the PDP arrived in the community. Following the incident, Jegede alleged that policemen supervised the attack on his campaign train by thugs. According to Jegede, who spoke through his campaign's head of media research, Kayode Faswa, the political thugs suspected to be from the camp of the ruling All Progressive Congress, APC, attacked supporters of the PDP upon their entry into Ipele. Specifically, the Divisional Police Officer, DPO, of Ipele was alleged to have backed the thugs all through the attack. Meanwhile, the camp of Governor Oluwarotimi Akulodoro has accused the PDP candidate of instigating the attack in the community, while emphasizing the PDP is crying more than the bereaved, the spokesperson of the Akeredolu Ayedatiwa campaign organization, Olabode Richard Olatunde, stated that Eitayo Jegede-san ordered his thugs to unleash coordinated attacks on the innocent people of Ipele and Ijebu in Owo local government area. Our people were traumatized with the sound of gunshots sporadically by Eitayo Jegede thugs in Owo today. Sensing that the PDP might be in the main town, Governor Oluwarotimi Akeredolu-san ordered his campaign convoy to take another route out of the town. Despite this, Eitayo Jegede and the PDP still went ahead to cause mayhem in Owo local government by attacking innocent members of the public and anyone with APC or Akeredolu branded caps or t-shirts. No fewer than 20 cars were destroyed, and many innocent people of Ipele and Ijebu Owo injured. Motorcycles were burned down, and the streets of Ipele littered with shells of bullets. This intimidation to scare the people of Owo from coming out to vote massively for their son will not work. The people are resolved to support Governor Oluwarotimi Akeredolu. We must also note that PDP went on when no one received them into Owo. They obviously prepared to come into the ancient town for attacks and violence, not to campaign. Recall about 2 weeks ago, hoodlums reportedly attacked convoy of Governor Akeredolu and Jegede. So this is not the first time that this is taking place in Ondo State. The political tension in Ondo State escalated on Wednesday, being September 16th, after the convoy of Governor Rotimi Akeredolu was reportedly attacked by thugs in Akoko Southwest local government area of the state. Another set of thugs also reportedly attacked the convoy of Eitayo Jegede, the candidate of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, in Ondo State governorship election. Several vehicles were reportedly destroyed following a clash between the APC and the PDP supporters in Ondo State. The attack occurred when the convoy of Akeredolu met with the convoy of Jegede in the town during campaigns. Akeredolu, the current Ondo State governor, who is seeking a second term on the platform of the All Progressive Congress, APC, has blamed the PDP for the attack. Richard Olabode, the spokesperson of the Akeloduru Ayedatiwa campaign organization, alleged that the thugs loyal to the PDP first attacked the governor's convoy in Oba Akoko and set the campaign vehicle ablaze. He called on the security agencies to investigate the attack on the governor and make the perpetrators face justice. But in a counter-accusation, the spokesperson of the PDP, Kennedy Pitati, blamed APC thugs for the attack on Jegede's convoy. The campaign organizations of the APC and the PDP candidates have pointed accusing fingers at each other. He alleged that the attackers alighted from the governor's convoy to attack the PDP campaign team. The Ondo State Police Command said it has deployed officers to calm the situation. Peter T. said some of Jegede's supporters sustained injuries and have been taken to the hospital for treatment. The Ondo State Police Command has confirmed the clash in the community. The spokesperson for the command, Tilio Ikoro, said mobile police have been deployed to curtail the crisis. All right, my wonderful people, this is all the news we have for you coming from Ondo State, saying in regards to Ondo election, saying that many were injured, while over 20 vehicles, motorcycles, were destroyed as APC and PDP supporters clash in Owo. Before I allow you to drop your comments and your opinion at the comment section, permit me to drop my own humble opinion. If I'm to say, first of all, we have to bear in mind that the Ondo governorship election is coming up on 10th of October. And both the two political parties, that of Rotimi and that of Jegede, have been clashing, they have been at loggerhead all this while. And in Ondo State, it's as if, as it stands now, the APC are the one holding the mantle of leadership in Ondo State. And I know that PDP will really want to take it, whether by force or by anything. Then they also want what happened in Edo State to happen in Ondo State. They would like to, the way they won in Edo State, for them to also want the win in Ondo State. And I know they will stop at nothing to realize their dreams. So I beckon on the federal government to look into the matters. I beckon on the men of the security force to make sure they calm the situation before the life of the citizen will be in question. All right, my wonderful people, I will allow you to watch the video to the end. But don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Also, do well to drop your comments and your opinion at the comment section. See you in my next video. Thank you.